Hello, welcome to this short tutorial dedicated to Autodesk Revit 2021, a building information model software used to make 2D and 3D models like floor plans, maps, houses, and buildings. Make sure to visit our YouTube channel and our official website to get extras, news, and participate in our exclusive giveaway campaigns. When opening Revit, this shows its homepage, where you can start from either a new Revit project or an existing one on the left, and also find several ready templates to use on the center. These include the models, which are complete project designs, and families, which are single object designs that can be imported into several model projects. These are divided in architectural for architectural environment, such as walls and doors, structural, focused on materials and basic skeletons, and systemic, dealing with tubes and conductors. In this beginning tutorial, we will see how to design a very simple architectural building starting from a new model project. The Revit workspace is made by the main preview on the center, several panels on the left side, and the ribbon bar on top. Collecting several drawing tools under the Architecture, the Structure, and the Systems tabs. In addition, you can use the down arrow to show the full list of tools collected, hovering over any if you need more help and information. To start realizing a building, we will use the tools inside the Build section of the Architecture tab, starting from the floor with the Floor tool. When you enable the Drawing tool, you enter inside the edit mode, with the Modify tab in green color, collecting several ways to draw the object chosen. In this case, the floor. Use Line, Arc, or Spline to draw straight or curved sides by fixing points on the workspace. Using the Escape key to stop drawing. Use Rectangle, Polygon, and Circle to drop regular shapes instead, using the Escape key to undo. You can use your mouse wheel to zoom in and out if you need. Revit includes several drawing aids to help you, such as snappings to object vertices, centers and intersections, and also dashed guidelines to directions and object extensions. It also shows length and angle measurements during any drawing in progress for better precision. To adjust snapping options and units to use, you can go to the Manage tab. Once you draw the basic shape of the floor, this remains in pink color, indicating that it is still a sketch. On top, under Mode, you can choose to approve the sketch with Finish or undo it with Cancel, exiting from the current edit mode. Only if you approve the floor, this will be rendered on the project with color and filling. Once the floor is made, you can enable the Wall tool to create the walls around its contours, using the same drawing tools under the Modify tab. You can enable the Line tool to draw side per side, or the Rectangle tool to follow the rectangle contours of the floor. The walls will join automatically if they intersect on the vertices. These walls are all shown as simple 2D blocks, being the default preview, a top-to-bottom 2D view on the project called Level 1, as shown on the tab on top. If you go to View, 3D View, you switch to a full 3D preview, customizable with the visualization tools on the right, including the 3D View Cube, and the full navigation wheel to pan and 3D rotate with orbit. In these 3D views, you can see the base of the walls laying on the ground plane, or level 1, spreading in height according to the value specified on top. From the project browser panel on the left, you can find the full list of 2D and 3D views available inside your project that you can open by double-clicking on these, and Manage by right-clicking. Let's check these. The floor plans, also called levels, are 2D views that show the project from top to bottom, starting from the ground plane with level 1 up to other levels at an increasing height from it. These are very useful to draw objects laying on bases like floors and walls. The elevations are 2D views showing the project from east, north, south, and west. Useful to check each object height in respect to the same levels defined, shown as dashed lines with their height value. These elevations are also placed on the levels view as simple blocks with defined direction. You can also create your own levels and elevations for extra height levels and points of view. To create a new level, open any elevation view and go to Level under the Architecture tab. Whereas to create a new elevation, open any level view and go to Elevation under the View tab. Then just place the block and set its range and depth view. Once the walls are in place, you can add doors and windows on it by using any 3D view or elevation view. Use the Door tool to place any door with its base on the ground plane or on any other level. And enable the Window tool to place any window on the walls. These doors and windows are examples of families, such as single object designs that can be ported into any Revit model. If you click on any family, you can use the Properties panel on the left to change its design and size in no time. You can find other families by using the Component tool. Once the walls are in place, you can use the Roof tool to draw any roof. Also, this tool takes as reference a level height, which is by default the ground level 1, which is not the right one for the roof. In this case, Revit will ask you to change the height level to use directly. This reference plane is called Workplane and can be checked on the preview by enabling Show under Workplane. Whereas you can use Set to change the level to take as reference. Once the work plane is correct, you can define the roof sketch in edit mode and apply it to render it as seen for the floor. In addition, if you have Defines Slope enabled, the roof slopes are managed automatically and marked as pink triangles next to each side. Whereas if you disable this option, the roof will be completely flat. But you can fully customize it with the shape editing options above. First, fix points and lines on the roof. Apply with the Escape key, and then move these as you like with the Modify Sub-Elements enabled. When no tools are enabled, you can click on any object to select it in blue color and start editing it. There are two main ways to edit an object. If you select the object, you can drag from its nodes and arrows to edit its basic properties, such as the height of a wall. You can also click and drag the object itself to move it, and use Ctrl and X, C, and V to cut, copy, and paste it. Use the Delete key to remove it. If you make any mistake, you can undo with Ctrl and Z. Inside the Modify tab, you have several editing tools you can use on the selected object, such as Rotate and Mirror. Make sure to hover over any tool to get help and tips about these if you need. Another way to edit the object is to change its basic shape. If you select the object and use the Edit button under Mode, you will enter again into edit mode to modify the basic sketch of the object on each of its vertices and sides composing it. Then use Cancel to undo or Finish to apply. You can also use the visual style at the bottom to improve the raw preview shown, or check the result of a rendering by going to View and then to Render. Whereas to save your project, use the Save button or Control and S. All Revit models are saved as .rvt files. Thanks for watching this short tutorial. Visit our YouTube channel for more outstanding and free content.